Dave Newell, the referee, Leon Stickel, one linesman. And where's the other big guy? Here he is. His name is Mike Civic. The Leafs shoot it in. Hitting already is Semenko. Bumping hard on the boards. Eiserman given a jolt by Burstrake. Near center ice. The Red Wings regrouping. And there's another shot by Burstrake. Lehman and Clark are the wingers. Here comes Clark. Look out. He gave DeLorme a shot just outside the Detroit blue line. A hard hit. Leafs still have it in the zone. Gill up the blue line. Tipped the pass to Courtnell. Courtnell gets set. Courtnell rolled it to the side of the net. Center! Score! Puck loose and Clark in the center ice area. Rolled it ahead. The Leafs are in it again. Clark! Low shot is blocked. Rebound is there. Again, they score! Inacek gets the second rebound. And the Leafs are out in a hurry. 2-0. Therrien finds a man down the right side. It is Verstrake shooting it in. Stefan knifed it away with the goal stick. The Leafs in after it. O'Connell bumped his man in the corner rather heavily. Verstrake got another shot thrown at him by Burr. And something developed in behind the play. Stefan is out of the net to take a swing at the Leaf player, Daou.
Daou dragged his foot as he went past the net and turned Stefan around. And Greg Stefan has got a history of losing his temper, twice been suspended for 8 games for stick swinging, went after Daou. I'm not sure that it was an attempt by Daou to upset them, but we have to remember that the Detroit player Probert ran over Reggett last night. Let's have a look and we'll see exactly what did happen. Now that's Daou being kind of shoved into Stefan by O'Connell. And Daou's stick came up and hit Stefan in the face, and he lost his temper, and I don't know how Dave Newell's going to see this one. Here's another look at it. You decide whether Daou, number 24 now, coming past, was pushed in or went in. What do you think, Bob?
I think the defenseman got a piece of him going by, and he could not help but hit Stefan as he went by. Stefan did not like it. And it's Murphy playing it in and going after it. Got away from it. Check just in time. Patsopoulos hit the boards hard. And he's been injured. Here's Preacher. Tried to stick handle in. And he was getting a late bump. Now they go at each other a little bit. Oates played it in. Back there is Gill. He fell. Gave it away. It comes back to Beach. Shot. Norwood into the corner and coming out for Detroit. Up to Gallant near center. He had some difficulty. Scott started in behind the play. Probert and Clark. Probert got the first two or three looks in. And is still going.
Probert can really fight, Bob, and he's got a big reach advantage on Wendell Clark.
They'll go for major penalties. Big Probert giving Clark a few shots from Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto. This is Hockey Night in Canada on CBC.
Clark and Probert had a little harmless collision here to start it off. The puck went up the ice, and they just stood there and fenced with each other. And it didn't look like it was going to develop into much till Clark did that. And now, of course, it went into a fight where I think Probert won on a clear-cut decision, Bob.
Probert and Clark fighting majors. But as you pointed out earlier, Harry, Lehman and Clark have played back there. No doubt they'll see some time back there before it's over. The Leafs are in.
Well, they've had a couple of linesmen injured this year, and they've pressed young Mike Civic, 6'8", from Vancouver. And I'm not so sure that his very presence may discourage a couple of guys from fighting. He may grab both of them, pick them up off the ground till the fight starts.
Forward throws it back, gave it away. Ferguson, but he couldn't get a shot. He was more surprised than anybody. Gill scored. Gill took the shot. Looked like it might have hit something in front of Stefan before it got the top corner. the Red Wings had O'Connell lugging it out. Up he goes with Gallant on the left side. Gallant rolled it back in front. It does near the line. And a scrap has started, and Semenko is in there with Probert. Probert, remember, gave it to Wendell Clark, and he's taking some now, but now he gets loose. And this is going to be a massive scrap because everybody is pairing off now. Semenko is still throwing hard right hands at Probert, even though the two linesmen are trying to keep them apart.
And isn't it strange that it's not Stickle who can't hold his man, it's Sivic who can't hold his man. But Semenko will definitely get the aggressor, the instigator.
And Semenko is still getting a right hand loose.
And Gerard Gallant may well have been the third man in. There was a third man, as he thought Probert was getting pounded badly, as Probert didn't throw a punch in the first half of this fight. And Gerard Gallant, 17, I think is telling Gill there, I didn't want to come in. But Semenko jumped Probert.
That looks like the Dave Semenko of old, because we know about his reputation. But you know, Harry, he quieted down for a while, but not tonight. Semenko is going to the lead fence. Gallant was, as you suspected, Harry, a third man in. He has gone to the Detroit dressing room. Semenko had gone to the penalty box with Probert and asked permission to go to the leaf room.
Well, I can tell you one thing. I remember seeing Semenko in his earlier day. Here's how the fight started. Probert doesn't know he's in one yet. He's still got a stick in his hands. And watch for number 17. He comes in to try and stop Probert from getting killed. Probert was just getting back into things. But that look in Semenko's eyes that you mentioned as he came to the penalty box reminded me of him when I coached in Vancouver, and he used to get upset a lot more often when he was younger, and he'd take come over past our bench. Guys were diving under the bench. They wanted no part of him at all. As well as...
Hold it. Probert and a fan have something going down here near the penalty box. Some fan was standing up and waving a white hanky, and Probert gave him a little liquid refreshment there, I think, from about 15 feet.
Well, those fans have got to be absolutely nuts to play with hockey players during the penalty box.
And Toronto's finest making sure that that fan is looked after.
For Detroit,
and he
Bob
might have
Probert,
to leave.
2 minutes roughing. Gerard Gallant, 2 minutes roughing and a game misconduct. For Toronto, Dave Semenko, 5 minutes fighting and a game misconduct. Time 10:18.
All this happens at 10:18. Semenko got a major and a game misconduct.
Well, they can give that, the referee can give that if he thinks that Semenko jumped Probert and the fight didn't result from a skirmish earlier, and I don't think there's any question about that.
Probert got a minor penalty for roughing, and Gallant of Detroit was the third man in.
And he gets two in a game.
He gets a roughing penalty and a game misconduct. Onto it, trying to hit Klima. Now Gill is up to center ice with Preacher and Fergus. Preacher coming into Gill, right in, score! He continued on that left side, and Fergus and Preacher moved it up to him. Good play by Preacher.
Peter Klima will be afraid to go to the bench. He just quit on Todd Gill and let him go to the net for that goal. And one thing that Peter has had is his troubles with Jock Demers, because he won't work at the defensive part of his game like he works at the offensive part. And there you can see Klima, who was well in front of Gill at the blue line. See right here, he just lets him go. And what a great pass by Preacher, and Todd Gill looked like a forward as he deked Stefan and stuck it in for the fifth goal.
O'Connell coming in, faked the shot. He put two wingers in, now he had to come back. Probert moving up after it. Richardson bumps Probert in on the board. Centered. Ashton fanned on his attempt. Iserman behind the net. Trying to dump it in front of Ashton. Iserman again. stopping with Probert in there. Probert now with a chance, but Richardson once more isn't covered. Probert hangs on to it. To the corner with it. Out to the line. Beach winding up. Shooting. Back down. Score. The rebound was there, and they wrapped it home. 5-2 as the Red Wings get one. Red Wings now led by Yzerman. He's the playmaker. Long shot. Drilled at the net. Another chance. And Reagan went down. And then was bumped lightly. Do not take too lightly of that fact.
Well, there's been about four times tonight when we've said, I'm not sure whether he went in on purpose or whether he was trying to go in. But remember, Probert ran Reagan over last night in Toronto, and that was one of the things that really disturbed Brophy. So I don't know how many of these have been accidental, but the players aren't asking if you're sorry. They just know you did it. Now here it is here. You decide whether Joey Kosher goes in on his own or decides to run over the goalie. A little bit of both, Bob, I think, although the puck was somewhere under Reagan, so I guess he'll say he was just trying to find it.
Richardson down on one knee to scoop that one ahead. Osborne hit by Norwood. Got him lined up. All the way to Lance. He left it there. Red Wings moving up after it. Behind the goal. Another penalty coming on this play, and I think maybe against Toronto.
I think Portnoy is going to get an elbowing penalty.
And a scrap now. Portnoy and a scrap. Sambo comes in. Watch out, folks. Sambo and I are afraid here on the ice.
Portnoy was very upset with Sean Burr. That's the fella he elbowed to get the original penalty. Then on the way to the box, he started up fighting Sean Burr. Portnoy doesn't fight very often, and as a matter of fact, neither does Sean Burr.
Norwood and Olchek have a hold of each other. They would go quickly, I'm sure. Is having a tough time holding Sean Burr, who wants to get at Cornwall.
Much more now that the linesman's got him than he did before, I notice.
Lance will keep it in, dumping it to the corner. Here comes Bill pinching in from the other side. Makes a play in front. Murphy going after the puck in the lead zone. Lance is back to watch him. Out centered at the score. Klima to Al Iafredi, and he's out the center, leaving it for Preacher. Preacher moving up, nailed at the line by Burr, and he's been hurt. Preacher hit hard by Sean Burr, and he's down on all fours.
Preacher looks better now. He gets on the wrong track here, and Sean Burr really nails him. Watch this, number 14. He tries to jump to get out of the way, but it's too late, Miro. And on the way down, thoughts of the L.A. earthquake ran through his mind, about 8.3 on the Richter scale.
Gill moving up, stopping. Had a notion to shoot. Nobody was open. Now he gives it to Osborne, who centers it. Went through Daou to the line. Lands to Daou in front. Rebound score! Richardson back. The rookie defenseman turning, giving it to Clark. Clark, soft pass through the middle to Olchek, in with Inicek. His shot stopped by Elliott. Clark ran into Ashton hard. Norwood goes in behind the net. Preacher in the corner. Dumped it in front. Purvis was open, but Norwood intercepted the pass. To Yzerman going in. Yzerman shot, scores! Beautiful rush and a dandy shot by Yzerman. Osborne in there. Roughing it up with Zombo in the corner. Kosher to center ice for Detroit. And he was nailed by Richardson. Trying to go in. That shook him up a bit. Kosher is heading for the Detroit bench on that hard hit by Luke Richardson.
Boy, it was a dandy, and Joe Kosher, it looks to me like his shoulder or his wrist, but he was on the bad end of a heck of a body check.
Here in Toronto, I'm Bob Cole with Harry Neal. With 2:48 left in the third period, the Toronto Maple Leafs are leading the Detroit Red Wings 7-4, and here's how it has been done more often than not tonight. Richardson throwing a hard check in on Kosher, who's hurt, as you see, and he's on the bench.
Not all good body checks. You have to go down. When you stop that suddenly, it hurts, and Joel Kosher looks like he's in severe pain on the Detroit bench.
Toronto Maple Leafs win it going away, and a rough one tonight at Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto, winning it 7-4 and out shooting Detroit 46-20. In just a moment, our Molson Cup three-star selection.